Today I'll be doing a presentation on my vision and reservation. Since I am from there affiliated, I might as well. Which is pretty cool since reservation is like one of the biggest ones right now, if not the biggest in the U.S. with like the size of it being like Rhode Island as a state. I like to think that overall, being a Oglala is a blessing for what our ancestors have went through of like almost being extinct kind of. And as well as like the boarding schools and all that in the past. And for our ancestors giving us next generations to be up next. Today on the reservation is actually a good place compared to the past, like in the 90s or 80s. We are expanding every day with like more facilities building for the youth and more opportunities as well as for people graduating. I mean, there's still like a lot of problems in the rest today, like people breaking rules or alcohol. What's in Spanish today is like, it's pretty cool. There's 5 high schools actually. There's Red Cloud, Pine Ridge, Voltec, Little Moonbeam, Little High School called Crazy Horse. There are a lot of cool places as well, but there's like, for example, the Top of the Wings, Candy Green, or somewhere. And also, Andrea also recently legalized weed, which is also pretty cool. They said that the owner of the first dispensary said we have a lot of different issues on the reservation, and through this new business venture, we're creating hope. Instead of drinking, I think this will like help the community a lot, because one of all is included in my attendance. And alcoholism was also pretty bad throughout the 90s through 2010s, before it was bad. The nearest alcohol place was only 3 miles away from the res. And it was said that once in a news article that it was like 2,000 beers or 3,000 beers a day was drained into the res by just the people itself. After they realized how bad it was, they forced that little town called White Clay to close down and stop selling alcohol. And a little while later in 2013, that's when they banned alcohol throughout the whole tribe. This is the map of our res, my res. You have a couple of districts. Iguala, you have Oglala, Pine Ridge. Iguala, Neem, Anderson, Portugal. Kyle, Wongley. It's pretty big. It's just mostly all just the plains and just a whole bunch of grass and stuff. But we are actually right next to Rapid City, which is also pretty cool. And we are associated with the Atlantic National Park. And so we all been there. It's a pretty good scenery. This is like a picture, visual picture of the Black Hills. There's like way better pictures, but we actually own the Black Hills. And our ancestors fought for it as well. So that's actually a blessing to have because it's pretty sacred to my culture. And they went to like, I guess like back in the day, the Wasija people went to the gold mines or something like that. So our reds or the people just fought it back. This is how close it was really. It was like 3 miles, 2 miles for like the alcohol away from town. But that's actually really bad too. We improved with healthcare. This one right here is the one in Pine Ridge. This one right here is in Kyle, and this one right here is in Wongley. The main one, I believe, is in Pine Ridge because they're expanding today too. They were only at 42 beds, and now they're at near 80 for hospitalized people. And I believe that they're expanding on all clinics was because of the death rate for them. The death percent for an adult, I believe, was 46. I think it became higher today. And most of it was alcohol and diabetes. And I believe that's why they're expanding. They're expanding as well in the positions available for nurses, doctors, dentists. And I think they have two surgeons in the Pine Ridge Clinic, which will really help out people. This actually happened recently too. But at Rapid City, there was like a Native guy that got killed. And in the hotel, it was pretty bad, so they banned Natives. And I think that was, I think that violated one of the treaties as well with the land, I think. I remember people were talking about that, so they, some, a lot of Natives from everywhere came to Rapid City and started boycotting the hotel. And even the manager of it, since she did make that decision on her own. But this is a brief demonstration of the Bigfoot battle. This happened, I think, this happened in 1876. The Lakotas, Cheyenne, and Arapaho warriors defeated the U.S. Army 7th Cavalry under the commandment of George Custer. I think that's why I would be thankful for being a lot of Lakota. Our leaders in battle were seeing who in today's words. They're both of what I love, which is pretty cool. So like we need the army, I guess. And, this is the leaders. This is Sitting Bull. And the other one right here is Crazy Horse. I looked online and I think I already knew this, but they just said that Crazy Horse, they were the highest picture too.